Welcome to FEU Roosevelt's 62nd Commencement Exercises of the Tertiary Education Division and the 56th Commencement Exercises of the Graduate School of Education, with this year's theme, Embracing the Challenge of Building a Better Normal. This is the second virtual graduation for our college and graduate students. This event celebrates the milestone of students of Batch 2021. Ladies and gentlemen, the singing of the Philippine National Anthem to be followed by the invocation to be led by Mr. Loy Baksal, summa cum laude, Master of Arts in Education major in Filipino.
Let's put ourselves in the presence of the Lord. Our gracious and loving Father, how marvelous are the works of Thy hands. Today, our hearts are filled with gratitude for all of Your wonderful gifts. Thank You for guiding us to this wondrous day, our graduation day. We give You thanks and praise for the goodness that shines in the relationships formed, wisdom gained, knowledge learned, and memories made through this university. God of grace and glory, there are things happening around us that we do not fully understand. Some of these things make us feel helpless and afraid. But even in the midst of this, we know that You are the Lord, and Your grace is sufficient during these strange and chaotic days. Lord, give us faith to persevere on the face of the unknown and the wisdom to make the decisions that guide us to where You want us to be. Teach us to listen closely to Your voice, that we would have a heart to obey Your word and do things in a way that will bring glory to Your name. We pray that You will equip us with every purpose You have for our lives and give us constant endurance to run the race well. Lord, this is the day that You have made. We are glad and rejoice in it. Thank You, Lord. All this we pray in the name of the strong deliverer, our only Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Friends, the administration, faculty, and staff of FEU Roosevelt Tertiary Education Division and Graduate School of Education.
the candidates for graduation from the Tertiary Education Division in Graduate School of Education will be presented to the President of FEU Roosevelt, Dr. Michael M. Alba, by the Dean, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo.
Dr. Michael M. Alba, President of FEU Roosevelt, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation from the College Department and Graduate School of Education, Class of 2021. They have satisfactorily completed the requirements prescribed by the Commission on Higher Education and are hereby recommended for their respective degrees of Bachelor of Science and Computer Science, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Educational Technology, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Educational Management, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Filipino, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Mathematics, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Science Education, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Social Studies, Master of Arts in Education, Major in English Studies and Instruction, Master of Arts Education, Major in Teaching in the Early Grade, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Special Education, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Guidance and Counseling, and their respective certificates, Teacher Certificate Program, 1-year Graduate Certificate in Teacher Education. I hereby petition for the confirmation of their completion and graduation.
By virtue of the power vested in me by the Board of Trustees of FE Roosevelt, I hereby confer upon you your respective degrees with all the privileges thereunto appertaining. Congratulations.
30-unit certificate in teacher education. Rowena Abarrientos. Abigail C. Basbas. Agbor Esong Efyong. Angeli L. Lasiste. Annalyn G. Gumanit. Archana Kumar. Armin Kritzinger. Ashlyn Shirley Bart Root Swaggers. Benjamin J. Kenyon. Benjamin Matthew Edmonds. Bufinder Kaur. Blessil May P. Camero. Brent Michael Cahan. Brian Jose D. Aba. Bro Roin Padraig Mune. Callum Seamus Kevin McLaughlin. Karina B. Loretta. Carmi Lou S. Orbe. Sally Castro. Catronica Binti Guldi. Cecilia B. Niepes. Chifumi Suzuki. Christopher Henry Rudd. Daniel Charles Hayes. Daruni Songsilawat. Darwin M. Espinosa. David Edward McCollister. Dawa Yang Chen. Darsana Bijoy Arangat. Diane Grace C. Baldomero. Divine G. Fuerte. Edisa Yivisi. Edrelyn T. Dakiwag. Efren C. Rosalda. A. Thu. Aileen R. Liwag. Ewen Cahill. Ernestine A. De Ramas. Ernie D. Orbe. Ethel Joy P. Esquera. Felix Obeng Dompre. Philomena G. Woodhead. Gandiswaran Gadithason. Geraldine D. Albarico. Gauri Darshini Kumaran. Grace Joy D. De Los Reyes. Graeme Francis Ollis. Guande Huang. Hanyufel Grael O. Balid. Helen S. Rosales. Jamie I. Kirk. Jamie Michael Bolton. J. Ann O. Kiera. Geraldine C. Morada. Jason S. Ragine. John May P. Ferraren. Jeffrey P. Dinoy. Jenny Rose A. Oben. Joan Mafedet S. Cueva. Jinky O. Navia. Joanna Marie C. Girarman. John Felix B. Montesino. Jonna May T. Rosales. Jonna Flor T. Saracanlao. Joseph G. Fitalvero. Joy C. Roble. Julie L. Politico. Juliet S. Ludovice. Julius A. Bustillo. Kai Chen. Kanchi Mehta. Karen L. Gomez Pulgar. Con Ong. Kurt Angelo M. Bansag. Leia J. Liwanagan. Lee John McGill. Liel C. Tayo. Lillian T. Tanyi. Limar T. Achero. Lorelie S. Cabrillas. Ludovico E. Honrada Jr. Maria Charito V. Hundok. Maria Joselini D. La Vega. Maria Cristina Y. Hermoso. Maria A. Kiani. Maria Jaina S. Piojo. Maria Lina S. Sari. Maria Turbian B. Pugoy. Marie Nila R. Mendoza. Mark Anthony S. Razote. Mark H. Bivoyet. Marnelli B. Cordero. Marta Choi. Mary Grace O. Tagaylo. Mary Jane D. Calderon. Mary Winsome Ann B. Santasera. Matthews Adam Biscup. Matjas Horvat. Melanio L. Comali. Melody J. Villaruz. Mary Chris B. Martinez. Micaela V. Discipulo. Michael Carlo M. Alejandro. Michael Marr. Michael Vincent A. Villamore. Michelle Rabi. Michelle D. Sipe. Michelle Smith. Miko M. Asentista. Molham Haddad. Nash Jean L. Sundongan. Natalie Neil G. Forte. Natalia Senko. Nena Richie R. Palmones. Nerfa F. Bartolome. Nikki Thomas Watson. Nieva L. Magallanes. Nympha P. Vicente. Nisha Edwin Pinto. Pema Norbu. Oscar Fernandez Santa Maria. Paula Q. Quaresma Freitas. Pauline V. Bonsilaw. Pingbo Ma. Loipilin and Chuan. Premlata Singh. Princess Casper A. Urdaneta. Princess Sheila A. Manco. Raymond Ray C. Lopez. Raymond T. Bantoto. Rechi M. Napagal. Riden Y. Paguntalan. Renalu B. Gubok. Ricardo A. Mascarinas. Richard John Albert Dow. Mark Rodil. Rupa Hemant Desai. Sakti Sudha Radha Krishnan. Samira Razdan. Sandeep Kumari. Sapna N. Patel. Sarah Jane B. Felias. Sean Robert Van De Linde. Annie Rao Sinagada. Seo Sinye. Sergey Zaitsev. Shaira P. Senok. Cheryl May B. Felias. Shipra Lakra. Sherlyn B. Akob. Siravich Joshua Chaumwangbon. Sithara Vinod. Srinivasa Rao Bitra. Stefan Van Papendorp. Swalen M. Ragarder. Suryadi Putra. Syed Asif Shah. Zaimon P. Kubiak. Teras A. Reda. Thomas David Ward. Usara D. Demagaya. Uygar Kanmaz. Valerie J. Mitchell. Vandana Mathur. Victor Muller Nicolas Henry Bambrozak. Vincent U. Corceles. Vin Min Pang. Vipin Kumar Shioran. Vivian P. Advincula. Sian Jane A. Arias. Xiaorui Zhang. Zufeng Wu. Zishan Raza Khan. Zuo Zhang. Adaugo F. Adaka. Adelowo Adeleke. Alexis L. Mutuk. Alan C. Malagueno. Andrew Manfredi. Angelito G. Espinosilla. Ankur Sharma. Anthony Richard Catalano. Atem Norkin. Aiden Lawrence. Ayush Sharma. Balbin Elkengne Bopda. Ben Hanks. Billy Joel J. Ordono. Bingfang Yu. Boris A. Bran Barrientos. Brent Wilson. Bridge Pegasus Burun. Carolyn R. Douglas. Charlene May D. Aganon. Christian D. Aranyes. Chung Hill James Miller. Clarissa Joy V. Donor. Colin M. Higgins. Connor J. Lennon. Cornelia S. Van Zyl. Craig Reynolds. David G. Kemp. David G. Harrison. David Petrak. David Westerman. Dennis Joven M. Bragas. Dania Sugatan. Diodon Tabot Orok. Dilovar Jobirov. Dimitri Kuznetsov. Dong He. Donna Bell S. Pangilinan. Duncan C. Wise. Diane May P. Tumasis. Dylan L. Massey. Eden Victoria A. Paladias. Elson Flores Mahilum. Elvin C. Mariano. Emmanuel Quabena Tano. Endurance I. Oyebochia. Eric John Gompertz. Felix Lawrence Francis. Gagandeep Singh. Garrett C. Gray. Genevieve C. Tanyongon, Guojin Zhang, Ginalen L. Sezong, Hamidreza Degan, Helen M. McKerney, Henry B. Dalagan, Imran Khan, Irina Voinova, Isia P. Hulao, Jason P. Lindley, Gila A. Pablo, Janagathan Ganesan, Jenilyn A. Flauta, Jesse L. Soldat, Johannes J. Van Zyl, John Aaron M. Gatdula, John F. Corrigan, John L. Yonga Ekema, John Tukuichi Watanabe, Jose Diego Bran Barrientos, Judith B. Dingal, Julie B. Ngoyngoyan, Julian R. Menet, Junicil O. Quiapo, Juraj Zamiknik, Carl Edric C. Ogatis, Kenneth E. Ocheda, Kevin Richard John, Kezang Dema, Kingsley Tange Ba, Christoph Sobala, Kyle Jacob Turner, Lalaine O. Sauri, Legion Arcadia, Leopoldo A. Guerrero, Levin Vadim, Liam McDermott, Leon Mariel D. Deterra, Logan Tracy Jefferson, Majerit B. Elambo, Manita Sambit de Cachor, Maria Grigoreva, Mariel P. Srimakut, Marietta C. Dichoso, Marilu L. Gan, Maris Fremel C. Corpus, Marjorie H. Algalar, Mark Anthony J. Labriaga, Marlon A. Henry, Matthew Todd, Maxwell B. Hirsch, Mejal S. Javeri, Michael D. Cleveland, Mildred D. Dante, Mohamed Ahmed O. Basala, Natamon Ritilert Napa, Neto Prasad, Nima Sheragi Shalostri, Nino B. Baksa, Nolida B. Bensila, Nutan V. Hemani, Oisin M. Doyle, Ola Amin A. Al-Alaune, Han Liu, Percy M. Hereda Galindo, Peter N. Jaff, Pichapak Jatuporn Mongkol, Pranjoti Saikia, Prince Ancoma, Ray Narel M. Carneser, Richard A. Ford, Ricky S. Santos, Rinzin Samdup, Robert H. Tuttle, Robert J. McMahon, Rojana Tantirapan, Romel B. Habal, Rosie C. Cox, Ruby Gonme Lupanglunglu, Rupal Dugar, Russell E. Lynch, Ruche V. Aurelio, Ryan E. Astudillo, Ryan Stephen Corbett, Samiksha Segal, Sarah J. Deacon, Scott Stephen MacPherson, Scott Stewart, Sean H. Naismith, Seksun Pukchit, Sergey Chumakov, Simon J. Mahon, Sisira Priyanta Aloysius A. Uwagedon, Srinivasulu Tadakaluru, Stephen Johnson, Sonny K. Maharhan, Tashi Chomo, Timothy M. Abraham, Tom Jones D. Mati, Tun Tun Zo, Vincent S. Smith, Wei Wei, Wigand Michlet, Wiljen M. Baral, William A. Tihan, Chaukong Ma, Yoshitaka Nakawoka, Zivel D. Descalzota. Graduates from the Tertiary Education Division. Reina Bula E. Flores, Bachelor of Science in Computer Science. Graduates from the Graduate School of Education, Master of Arts in Education, Major in Educational Management. Amy M. Alam, Cum Laude, Thesis Title, Involvement of Parents of Kindergarten Pupils in Distance Learning. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Sheila L. Cirilia, Cum Laude, Thesis Title, Management Styles of the School Heads in Elementary Schools in Antipolo City. Advisor, Dr. Romel Z. De Leon. Riza P. De Guzman, Thesis Title, The Lived Experiences of Public High School Principals Towards Transformational Leadership. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Alpino P. Esquerdo, Thesis Title, Best Practices of Master Teachers in Instilling Classroom Discipline, a Phenomenological Study. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Carl Liel B. Lim, Magna Cum Laude and Loyalty Awardee. Thesis Title, Job Satisfaction in Relation to Classroom Performance of Secondary Education Teachers of FEU Roosevelt. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Gloria P. Lumibao, Thesis Title, The Level of Teacher-Parent Partnership on the Implementation of Distance Learning. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Rhea C. Peñaranda, Thesis Title, Parents' Knowledge, Attitude, and Perception on Teacher Turnover in a Private Learning Institution, The Case of OLOPS. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Efren G. Tamayo, Thesis Title, Financial Literacy of a Public Elementary School Teachers in Baras District, Basis for a Proposed Action Plan. Advisor, Dr. Maricris R. Tadyoan. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Educational Technology. Lorena D. De Vera, magna cum laude, thesis title, Assessments and Utilization of TLE Teachers on Flipped Classroom as an Instructional Strategy. Advisor, Professor Marion Jude M. Gorospe. Melanie P. Del Rosario, magna cum laude, thesis title, Teacher's Level of Satisfaction on the Use of Online Teaching Platforms in a Public School in Marikina. Advisor, Dr. Romel Z. De Leon. Riza T. Lerit, thesis title, The Use of Book Reveal Augmented Reality Mobile App Tool for Thesis Writers of Marikina Polytechnic College. Advisor, Professor Marion Jude M. Gorospe. Christine Joy B. Sison, magna cum laude, thesis title, Level of Skills in Emerging Technologies Used in Teaching in Talim Island. Advisor, Dr. Romel Z. De Leon. Maria Apasra R. Somo, magna cum laude, thesis title, Assessment on the Use of Learning Management System of Two Private Higher Education Institutions. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Pinky P. Tapel, magna cum laude, thesis title, Evaluation in Using Online as Assessment in Synchronous Learning. Advisor, Dr. Romel Z. De Leon. Master of Arts in Education, major in Teaching in the Early Grades. Mirasol G. Avillanosa, thesis title, Managing Discipline Among Kindergarten Pupils in Mayamot Elementary School. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Diaryl D. Bass, thesis title, The Use of Marungko Approach in the Online Learning and Reading Proficiency Among Kindergarten Pupils. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Gemma C. Bersamin, thesis title, Lived Experiences of Kindergarten Teachers in Using Creative Approach. Advisor, Dr. Dondon B. Buensuceso. Eliza B. Bracamonte, magna cum laude, thesis title, The Alternative Delivery Modalities in Transitioning Kindergarten Pupils to the New Normal. Advisor, Dr. Sandra Lee P. Servitilio. Luthgarda P. Buhayo, magna cum laude, thesis title, Self-Learning Materials or SLMs in Reading Literacy Among At-Risk Readers in English. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Jeneline P. Caneta, thesis title, Strategies in Developing Phonemic Awareness Through Information and Communication Technology or ICT in Kindergarten, School Year 2020 to 2021. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Rowena P. Castillo, thesis title, Lived Experiences of Kindergarten Teachers in Teaching Beginning Reading. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Manuela G. De La Cruz, thesis title, Lived Experiences of Grade School Teachers on the Learning Delivery Modality During the COVID-19 Pandemic. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Myla L. Evangelio, thesis title, Self-Learning Kit Supplementary Material and Developing Comprehension Skills in Filipino. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Evelyn A. Fatalia, thesis title, Challenges Encountered by the Grade 4 Learners in the Implementation of Modular Distance Learning. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Diana Lee B. Gimari, thesis title, The Use of RACE Program in Developing the Reading Level of Grade 3 Readers at Risk Through Distance Learning. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Joanne P. Igros, thesis title, Supplementary Self-Learning Materials in Reading Readiness in Mother Tongue for Distance Learning. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Melissa B. Madrona, thesis title, Family Involvement in the Utilization of Modular Distance Learning Approach in the Academic Performance of Grade 1 Pupils. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Roslyn F. Mari, thesis title, using songs and stories in teaching mathematics for kindergarten pupils. Advisor, Dr. Zandra Lee P. Servitilio. Florita B. Pascua. Thesis title, Parental Involvement in Using Modular Approach in Academic Learning of the Grade 2 Pupils. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dodds. Rachelle B. Rupa. Thesis title, Utilization of Play-Based Approach in Teaching Alphabet and Phonemic in Kindergarten. Advisor, Dr. Maricris R. Tadyoan. Lizette Marie B. Sunier. Thesis title, Working Mother's Involvement in Children's Online Learning. Advisor, Dr. Crisanta C. Buri. Dali B. Telan. Thesis title, Status on the Implementation of Early Language Literacy and Numeracy Program Among Kindergarten Teachers. Advisor, Dr. Maricris R. Tadyoan. Nympha D.C. Bautista. Thesis title, Classroom Management Technique in Promoting Anti-Bullying in the Classroom. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Social Studies. Christine May E. Atienza, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Evaluation on the Teaching Effectiveness of the Social Studies Teachers, Basis for Professional Training. Advisor, Professor Jason C. Carlos. John Emmanuel R. Batakan. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Don Antonio de Zuzuaregui Senior Memorial Academy Students Using the Learn Cycle. Advisor, Professor Jason C. Carlos. Anthony B. Bulaoro. Thesis title, Students' Awareness on Social Issues in Relation to Their Academic Performance in Grade 10 Social Studies Class. Advisor, Professor Jason C. Carlos. Maria Ive M. Cervantes. Thesis title, The Effects of Gamification Strategy in Teaching Contemporary Issues. Advisor, Dr. Dondon B. Buensuceso. Lani D.G. Domingo. Thesis title, Pedagogy and Technology Literacy Level of Teachers in Social Studies During the New Normal. Advisor, Professor Jason C. Carlos. Rose Ann D. Feigmani, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, The Use of Inquiry-Based Technology in Teaching Economics to Grade 9 Students of Xavier School. Advisor, Dr. Barbara W. Fernandez. Melissa C. Guzman. Thesis title, Stress Level and Teachers' Performance in the New Normal. Advisor, Professor Jason C. Carlos. Roselle P. Lorente. Thesis title, Utilization of Game-Based Learning in Teaching World History. Advisor, Dr. Romel Z. De Leon. Mark Alvin R. Malaya. Thesis title, Use of Strategic Instructional Materials or SIM in Araling Panlipunan Among Grade 10 Students at Teresa National High School. Advisor, Professor Jason C. Carlos. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Filipino Education. Hedhedia C. Antonio. Thesis title, Gamit ng Online Learning Platform sa Pagtuturo ng Filipino sa Panahon ng New Normal. Advisor, Dr. Vidal S. Mendoza Jr. Brian D. Aurelio, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Gamit at Kabisaan ng Mga Online Video-Based Learning Materials sa Pagtuturo at Pagkatuto sa Filipino, Grade 9. Advisor, Professor Willie L. De La Cruz. Sharina May C. Barasi. Thesis title, Antas ng Kabiguan sa Pagbasa ng Mga Mag-aaral sa Ikapitong Baitang. Advisor, Professor Willie L. De La Cruz. Geneva D.C. Barrientos, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Bisa ng Paggamit ng e-book sa Pagtuturo at Pagkatuto ng Ibong Adarna sa Ikapitong Baitang. Advisor, Dr. Vidal S. Mendoza Jr. Loy G. Baksal, summa cum laude. Thesis title, Mga Karanasan ng Mga Guro sa Filipino sa Pagsasagawa ng Online Distance Learning Modality. Advisor, Professor Willie L. De La Cruz. Israel G. De Ocampo, cum laude. Thesis title, Pagtukoy at Pagsusuri sa Diskurso at Tema ng Resiliency sa Mga Kwentong Aklat Ukol sa Pandemya ng COVID-19. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Cruzette C. Gurieza, thesis title, Level sa Pagkatuto ng Mag-aaral Gamit ang Animasyon sa Pag-aaral ng El Filibusterismo sa Ikasampung Baitang. Advisor, Professor Willie L. De La Cruz. Mary Ann B. Ihares, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Level ng Kahandaan at Kasanayan ng Mga Guro sa Pagtuturo ng Filipino sa Online at Modular Learning. Advisor, Dr. Vidal S. Mendoza Jr. Jonathan B. Javier, Summa Cum Laude. Thesis title, Kabisahan ng Paggamit ng Module at Sinkronisasyon sa Pagtuturo ng Panitikan sa Ikasampung Baitang sa Panahon ng Pandemya. Advisor, Dr. Vidal S. Mendoza Jr. Renato H. Hilo, Cum Laude. Thesis title, Kabisahan ng Pagtuturo ng Tula Batay sa Teoryang Pampanitikan Tungo sa Pangunawa ng Mga Mag-aaral. Advisor, Professor Willie L. De La Cruz. J.R. M. Verick, Thesis title, Kabisaan ng Paggamit ng Biswal, Verbal at Pandamdam sa Online na Pagtuturo. Advisor, Dr. Vidal S. Mendoza Jr. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Mathematics Education. Gerald S. Andres, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Development and Validation of the Proposed Self-Learning Package on Selected Concepts in Mathematics 8. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Gina S. Katapang, Cum Laude. Thesis title, Academic Performance in Mathematics and Home Online Modality Used by SHS Students. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. ID L. Espina, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, The Use of Mathematical Manipulatives in Teaching Geometry. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Joseph S. Lara. Thesis title, Development and Validation of Technology-Based Instructional Materials for Grade 8 Mathematics. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Lenny A. Lopez, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Development and Validation of Self-Paced Instructional Material in Mathematics 9. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Jomelin A. Quijano, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Techno-Pedagogical Concepts and Skills of Primary Teachers. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Sarah Jane T. Tuplano, Summa Cum Laude. Thesis title, Synchronous versus Asynchronous, The Effects on Student Academic Achievement and Attitude Towards Mathematics. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Jomil U. Vallespin, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Development and Evaluation of Supplementary Digital Learning Worksheets in Mathematics 10. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Science Education. John Cyrus L. Doblada, Summa Cum Laude. Thesis title, Relationship of Students' Demographics to Their Environmental Attitude in a Non-Classroom Setting. Advisor, Dr. Romel Z. De Leon. Edna C. Escribano, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Feeding Program in Relation to the Academic Performance of Grade 8 Students School Year 2019-2020. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Christy Marie T. Esquerdo, Cum Laude. Thesis title, Use of Contextualized Instructional Materials to Teach Earth Science in a Blended Learning Modality. Advisor, Professor Elizabeth S. Viridiano. Arnold Ryan U. Mercado. Thesis title, Perceptions of Grade 11 Teachers in the Implementation of the K-12 Program in the Senior High School. Advisor, Professor Elizabeth S. Viridiano. Jennifer V. Palinlin. Thesis title, Study Habits of Grade 7 Students During Modular Distance Learning Modality. Advisor, Professor Elizabeth S. Viridiano. Michelle F. Rolliano, Summa Cum Laude. Thesis title, The Use of Strategic Intervention Material or SIM in Teaching Science to Grade 4 Pupils. Advisor, Professor Elizabeth S. Viridiano. Master of Arts in Education, Major in English Studies and Instruction. Jenna Ariana E. Adriano. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Teachers in English in Teaching Reading. Advisor, Dr. Mark Ryan R. Hernandez. Joy M. Avellino. Thesis title, An Evaluation of the Special Program in Journalism of Casimiro A. Inares Senior Memorial National High School. Advisor, Dr. Zandra Lee P. Servitilio. Between A. Ayalin, Summa Cum Laude. Thesis title, The Use of Communicative Language Teaching Approach as Intervention Program to Improve Speaking Skills Among Grade 6 Pupils. Advisor, Dr. Dondon B. Buensuceso. June Ann C. Barion, Cum Laude and Loyalty Awardee. Thesis title, The Lived Experiences of Teachers in Code Switching. Advisor, Dr. Crisante C. Buri. Danica A. Bibita. Thesis title, Use of English Comic Strips in Facilitating Reading Comprehension Among Grade 8 Students. Advisor, Dr. Crisante C. Buri. John Salvador R. Buque. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Senior High School Using Modular Learning Approach. Advisor, Dr. Alma Emerita V. De La Cruz. Brenda L. Collado. Thesis title, E-book Reading Behaviors and Attitudes of Junior High School Students. Advisor, Dr. Barbara W. Fernandez. Jonalyn T. De La Cruz. Thesis title, Utilizing Content and Language Integrated Learning or CLIL in Enhancing the Reading Skills of Grade 8 Students. Advisor, Dr. Mark Ryan R. Hernandez. Rydell Marco R. Encabo, Cum Laude. Thesis title, The Lived Experiences of Tertiary Educators Transitioning into Senior High School Level. Advisor, Dr. Crisante C. Buri. Jocelyn P. Escorpizo. Thesis title, Teachers' Communication Strategies During Online Class. Advisor, Dr. Crisante C. Buri. Mary Rose P. Gonzalez, Cum Laude. Thesis title, Looking Through the Lens, A Critical Discourse Analysis of Maria Felisa H. Batacan's Smaller and Smaller Circles. Advisor, Dr. Barbara W. Fernandez. Deborah A. Humiliano. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Senior High School English Teachers in Handling Students with Difficulty in Reading. Advisor, Dr. Alma Emerita V. De La Cruz. Angelica P. Juan. Thesis title, The Relationship of English Language Proficiency and Teaching Anxiety Among Shepherd Angels Christian School Incorporated Teachers. Advisor, Dr. Crisante C. Buri. Kimberly P. Liwanag. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Teachers Teaching the Dumagat Learners. Advisor, Dr. Zandra Lee P. Servitilio. Maria Ana Luzel O. Manabat, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Performance of Out-of-Field Teachers in Selected Senior High Schools in the Division of Antipolo City. Advisor, Dr. Alma Emerita V. De La Cruz. Mary Ann T. Ortiz. Thesis title, Use of PQ4R Text Strategy Through Modular Instruction Facilitating the Reading Comprehension Skills of Grade 9 Students. Advisor, Dr. Angelita L. Santa Ana. Shella May C. Rammer, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Online Corrective Reading Intervention in Improving Students' Reading Comprehension Level of Grade 8 Students of Silangan National High School. Advisor, Dr. Mark Ryan R. Hernandez. Jennifer Fria F. Ramos, Magna Cum Laude. Thesis title, Techno-Pedagogical Concepts and Skills of Primary Teachers. Advisor, Dr. Alma Emerita V. De La Cruz. Elisel J. Rodulio. Thesis title, Impacts of Kaizen Intervention on Students' Reading Comprehension and Reading Attitude. Advisor, Dr. Mark Ryan R. Hernandez. Bea Patricia E. Santos, summa cum laude. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Teachers in English in Providing Corrective Feedback. Advisor, Dr. Mark Ryan R. Hernandez. Cindy C. Santos, magna cum laude. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Teachers Using Facebook as Extension for Teaching. Advisor, Dr. Zandra Lee P. Servitilio. Joanna C. Vasquez, summa cum laude. Thesis title, Lived Experiences of Primary Public School Teachers in Implementing the Modular Distance Learning Modality. Advisor, Dr. Zandra Lee P. Servitilio. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Special Education. Helen C. Amoete, magna cum laude. Thesis title, Lived Experience of Special Education Teachers Coping in Distance Learning During the COVID-19 Pandemic. Advisor, Dr. Bernardita I. Tiamzon. Katrina Bianca C. Ancajas, cum laude. Thesis title, Blended Learning Modality for Learners with Special Education Needs, Its Challenges and Opportunities in the New Normal, School Year 2020 to 2021. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Charmaine F. Antonio, magna cum laude. Thesis title, Parental Involvement in Academic Performance of Learners with Special Needs in Concepcion Elementary School. Advisor, Dr. Dondon B. Buensuceso. Gloria C. Bulos, cum laude. Thesis title, Teachers' Emergency Medical Responses to Learners with Autism Spectrum Disorder. Advisor, Dr. Sandra Lee P. Servitilio. Christine L. Dalida, thesis title, Teacher's Perspective on Partial Mainstreaming and Self-Contained Program. Advisor, Dr. Dondon B. Buensuceso. Aigeli G. De Guzman, thesis title, Perceptions of Regular Education Teachers Towards Inclusive Education. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Liza S. Mystica, thesis title, Perception of Teachers on the Implementation of Inclusive Education. Advisor, Dr. Frederick Edward T. Favella. Cynthia P. Pesigan, thesis title, Teachers' Competence in Managing the Behaviors of Children with Special Needs in an Inclusion Program in Relation to Their Academic Performance, Basis for Development Program. Advisor, Professor Elizabeth S. Viridiano. Marie Bernadette A. Reyes, thesis title, Employers' Perceptions on Employability of Persons with Disability in Antipolo City. Advisor, Dr. Dondon B. Buensuceso. Queenie Eliza G. Salinas, cum laude. Thesis title, Beyond Abilities, Understanding the Lived Experiences of Parents of Learners with Intellectual Disability. Advisor, Dr. Bernardita I. Tiamzon. Chelsea F. Tanwatko, magna cum laude. Thesis title, Effects of the Developed Individualized Education Plan Self-Learning E-Module on the Skills and Perceptions of Special Education Teachers. Advisor, Dr. Bernardita I. Tiamzon. Master of Arts in Education, Major in Guidance and Counseling. Bibelita B. Aguila, thesis title, Lived Experiences of Grade 10 Teachers in the Use of Remote Learning Methods. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Father Virgilio S. Del Mundo Jr. OFM, cum laude. Thesis title, A Phenomenological Research on Doing Formation for the Formants in the Seminary. Advisor, Professor Catherine R. Dolls. Gracia G. Deesen, magna cum laude. Thesis title, The Effects of a Mental Health Handout on the Psychological Well-Being of Students Amidst the COVID-19 Pandemic. Advisor, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo. Maria Flor de Liz A. Guevara, thesis title, The Lived Experiences of Public School Teachers Who Recovered from COVID-19. Advisor, Dr. Frederick Edward T. Favella. Eve Joy M. Hatte, magna cum laude, thesis title, Use of Modified Prayer as a Mindful Exercise for the Emotional Intelligence of Grade 11 Students. Advisor, Dr. Nancy C. Rios. Anthony Edward G. Herrero, cum laude, thesis title, The Concept and Perceived Gratifications on Facebook Usage of Post-Millennials. Advisor, Dr. Barbara W. Fernandez. Cleo Faye F. Loretta, thesis title, The Relationship Between Persistence and Life Goals, Motivation and Self-Efficacy Among Working College Students. Advisor, Professor Christina T. Cheng. Dominic Martin D. Linghap, Magna Cum Laude, thesis title, Lived Experiences of Volunteer Crisis Line Workers in Terms of Their Emotional Resilience and Mental Health. Advisor, Dr. Nancy C. Rayos. Lizelle Ann Marie O. Manabat, Magna Cum Laude, thesis title, Lived Experiences of Guidance Counselors in Rizal Province During COVID-19 Pandemic. Advisor, Dr. Frederick Edward T. Fabella. Marian Adelaide A. Santos, thesis title, Virtual Emotional Social Support, Students' Resilience During the COVID-19 Pandemic. Advisor, Dr. Barbara W. Fernandez. Inelda V. Martinez, thesis title, Stress and Burnout in Relation to the Teaching Performance of Teachers of Lupang Pangako Elementary School. Advisor, Dr. Barbara W. Fernandez. Citadel R. Pulhin, thesis title, Anxiety of Mothers and Maintenance of Family Well-Being Amidst the COVID-19 Pandemic. Advisor, Dr. Virgilio F. Kim. Soledad A. Tambawan, thesis title, An Evaluation of the Senior High School Career Guidance Program in Selected Private Schools in Marikina City and San Mateo Rizal. Advisor, Professor Christina T. Cheng. Lenny A. Tiamzon, Magna Cum Laude, thesis title, Using Positive Psychology as an Intervention for Pupils with High Anxiety Level. Advisor, Dr. Mark Ryan R. Hernandez. Manuel Leo D. Umali, thesis title, The Relationship Between Personality Traits and Classroom Performance Evaluation of Teachers at Pasig Central Elementary School, Basis for Proposed Intervention. Advisor, Dr. Frederick Edward T. Fabella. The Batch Valedictorian of the Tertiary Education Division in Graduate School of Education, Ms. Between Ayalin, summa cum laude, Master of Arts in Education, major in English, will deliver her valedictory address.
To the members of the Board of Trustees of FEU Roosevelt, headed by Chairman Aurelio R. Montinola III, Dr. Michael M. Alba, President of FEU Roosevelt, Trustee Juan Miguel M. Luz, Commencement Speaker, Dr. Alma Emerita V. De La Cruz, Senior Vice President of FEU Roosevelt, Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo, Dean of the FEU Roosevelt Tertiary Education Division and Graduate School of Education, to our dear professors and faculty members, beloved parents, family, and friends, fellow graduates, a congenial day to all. Even a global pandemic would be powerless to halt this watershed moment in our lives. I believe that everyone is in a good mood and jubilant because we have survived our postgraduate studies. However, have we considered why we're pursuing higher education? What is our primary objective in completing our master's degree? I am certain that the primary reason is to advance our careers. I have no plans to complete my master's degree. My objective was to enroll in units and earn certificate to satisfy academic requirements, which is a requirement for a promotion. When I completed my academic requirements, the opportunity to apply for a promotion presented itself. As Benjamin Franklin stated, investment in knowledge always pays the best interest. I was promoted to master teacher in 2019. I was already content with my teaching career, and thus my motivation for completing the race was dwindling. I am sure that each of us here, dear graduates, has experienced this ambivalence about whether or not to finish the race. My husband was even teasing me each semester that I enrolled. He was constantly inquiring as to my commitment to completing my MA. This partially motivated me to persevere. Juggling motherhood, studies, and a teaching career was never easy. You can imagine how precious and sweet this moment is to me. I was just hoping to complete my master's degree, and yet, here I am in front of you all delivering this speech on behalf of the graduates. Indeed, I am indebted to God for this moment, as He has blessed me abundantly over the last few years, and I could not have asked for anything more. I would like to share this verse from Proverbs 19, verse 20 and 21 with you. Listen to the advice and accept instruction, that you may gain wisdom in the future. Many are the plans in the mind of a man, but it is the purpose of the Lord that will stand. Finding a reason for pursuing higher education will enable us to maintain our motivation and overcome the obstacles we will face along the way. Discovering our purpose enables us to envision meaning in our life. As such, it is associated with vocation. Having said that, understanding our life purpose and why we're pursuing a postgraduate degree equipped us to take the next step. And where we take these steps is critical in determining where we will pursue our postgraduate studies. I earned 18 education units at FEU Roosevelt. My mother-in-law encouraged me to consider enrolling at FEU Roosevelt to jumpstart my teaching career, as she earned her master's degree in education from Roosevelt in Lamuan. I recall her saying, "Magaling ang Roosevelt College," because Roosevelt is well known for its CTE programs, Center for Teacher Education. Indeed, I owe a debt of gratitude to FEU Roosevelt for igniting my commitment and passion for teaching. It is owing to FEU Roosevelt that I discovered my life's purpose, which is to teach. This institution places a premium on resilience, competence, and integrity. FEU Roosevelt provides students with the highest quality education possible. I recall that prior to taking my teacher licensure exam, FEU Roosevelt provided a review course that guaranteed our success on the exam. Yes, I passed the LET in the first take, despite the fact that I took only 18 units. Can you imagine how rigorous our curriculum is? To summarize my lengthy story, I returned to FEU Roosevelt, this time to pursue postgraduate studies. Why at the same institution? Clearly, because FEU Roosevelt became a significant part of my teaching career. It is the reason I enjoy my career as a teacher, and FEU Roosevelt played a significant role in my promotion. I am confident in stating that FEU Roosevelt provides the highest quality education for students who aspire to be someone someday. Completing our postgraduate studies has never been straightforward. It was made even more difficult for us by the fact that we are also working. While I was completing my study, my mother became ill with COVID-19 and was hospitalized for 2 weeks. I was on the verge of giving up the time due to a lack of focus. But there was this force that compelled me to finish the race and return to my track. It was the value of resilience that our alma mater instills in us constantly. A resilience that no matter how difficult life can be, we can still cope with it and bear the hardships until we achieve our life goals. These three values of resilience, competence, and integrity will always be an integral part of me, just as F.E. Roosevelt will always be an integral part of me. I was extremely fortunate to be surrounded by people who served as catalysts throughout my postgraduate academic years. And I would like to begin by expressing my heartfelt appreciation to my thesis advisor, Dr. Dondon Buensuceso, who has been extremely supportive and accommodating each time I have sent him a message, and who has shared his expertise and technical guidance in order for me to deliver a successful oral defense. Dr. Mark Ryan Hernandez, Dr. Barbara Fernandez, and Dr. Victor T. Tabuzo deserve special recognition for sharing their brilliance and providing remarkable and constructive feedback during my oral defense. Additionally, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to my former professors at FE Roosevelt, Dr. Angelita Santa Ana, Dr. Emily B. Aurelius, Professor Teresita Lopez, Professor Myrna L. Cruz, Professor Clint Richard L. Chua, and Professor Greg Manalo. Similarly, the acknowledgement should be extended to FEU Roosevelt's non-teaching personnel, including the library staff, registrar, accounting staff, and in particular to Mrs. Ellen Martinez, who has always been approachable and helpful to not only me, but to each of us. My expression of gratitude will be incomplete if I do not mention those close to me. As expected, my first appreciation goes to my husband, who supported me throughout, particularly in terms of paying my tuition fees, and to my two daughters, Angelica and Aliza, who inspired me to work harder because they are both academic achievers. This is also to express my heartfelt gratitude to our school's head, Madam Maria Bernadette A. Pablo, who pushed me to complete my MA, as well as to all of the grade 6 advisors and their students who assisted me with my study for their cooperation and support. To the teachers in grades 2 and 3 who work under my leadership, I appreciate your support and understanding. I have asked myself several times why I am still required to study. I already have a fulfilling life, a job I enjoy, a family that is extremely supportive, brother and sisters, and a simple and quiet existence. However, my thirst for knowledge and desire to always be a better version of myself continue to burn within me. As John Maxwell so eloquently stated, successful and unsuccessful people do not vary greatly in their abilities. They vary in their desires to reach their potentials. It is more than just a promotion. It is about reaching out to those who can help you, who you can coach and mentor, and with whom you can share your knowledge. We, the class of 2021, have reached this stage of our postgraduate studies, despite the pandemic. Without a doubt, we encountered numerous obstacles and uncertainties. However, we did not allow these obstacles to conquer us and defeat us. Our resilience saw us through, while our competence and integrity will lead us through the next days. But today, let us be thankful and celebrate our small victories. With immense pride, congratulations, Batch 2021. We made it. Keep yourself safe and may God bless us all.
Thank you, Ms. Ayaline, for that heartfelt message. Now, to provide a musical interlude, let us welcome Jaiko Polikit, Bachelor of Secondary Education, Major in Science, and Luis Marie Ruizol, Bachelor of Secondary Education, Major in English.
a time I pack my dreams away. Living in a shell, hiding from myself.
There was a time when I was so brave. I thought I'd reach the end, but baby, that was then. I am little more than I asked the days. This is my now, and I'm living in the moment. As I look around, I can't believe what I see. My fears behind me, gone are the shadows and clouds. There was then, this is mine now.
I have the courage like never before. Yeah.
I said a goodness, but I'm ready for more.
Ready for more. Shadows and dust. That was then. This is my now. As I'm living in the moment, as I look around, I can't believe that I see. Nothing's behind me. Gone are the shadows and dust. This is my now.
This is my now.
We are very honored today to be graced by the presence of a well-distinguished commencement speaker. Our commencement speaker is an educator and public policy analyst. He is a senior fellow of the FEU Public Policy Forum and a consultant and writer in education policy studies for international organizations and Philippine educational institutions. He was the undersecretary in the Department of Education, handling finance and administration for the country's largest bureaucracy in 2002 to 2006. His overseeing the management side of the education bureaucracy resulted in hundreds of short articles on education management and three books on learning and teacher development since then. After the Department of Education, he served a term as the president of the International Institute of Rural Reconstruction, or IIRR, an international development NGO headquartered in the Philippines, but whose program of work in natural resource management, rural development, and human capacity building was carried out in Southeast Asia, parts of China, in East Africa. After IIRR, he returned to education to serve as the Associate Dean and Head of School of the Stephen Zweli Graduate School of Development Management at the Asian Institute of Management. The lead program of the school was the Master in Development Management, or MDM program, which brought graduate students and scholars from South Asia, Southeast Asia, China, the Pacific Islands and Papua New Guinea, Central Asia, and North America for 1 year of graduate study. He was also involved in the AIM Public Policy Forum and the Ramon V. Del Rosario Senior Center for Corporate Social Responsibility. After retirement, he continues as adjunct faculty at AIM. He is the chairman of the Philippine Center for Population and Development, or PCPD, and sits on a number of nonprofit foundation boards as well as two universities. He studied classics, philosophy, and political science as an undergraduate. He has a master in public administration from the John F. Kennedy School of Government at Harvard University, where he was an Edward S. Mason Fellow in International Development. Friends, ladies and gentlemen, our commencement speaker, Trustee Juan Miguel Luz.
Can we build a better tomorrow for the Philippines? Dr. Lourdes Reyes Montinola, Chair Emeritus of the Far Eastern University. Mr. Aurelio Reyes Montinola III, Chair of the FEU Group. Dr. Michael Alba, President of Far Eastern University. Dr. Alma de la Cruz, Executive Vice President and Head of FEU Roosevelt. Dr. Victor Tabuso, Dean of Tertiary Education and Graduate Education at FEU Roosevelt. To the faculty of FEU Roosevelt, greetings. And to the graduates, the 2021 graduates of FEU Roosevelt who are completing their undergraduate and graduate studies, congratulations on achieving this milestone in your education and in your professional life. You are graduating in a unique period in world history, in the midst of a global pandemic. This coronavirus is a once-in-a-century occurrence. The last time a global pandemic of this magnitude occurred was in 1918 with the Spanish flu, also known as the Great Influenza. The Spanish flu raced around the world for 3 years, killing an estimated 50 million people. It came in four successive waves before herd immunity was achieved and the coronavirus was finally controlled. There have been many regional pandemics since, but nothing of a global scale until this COVID-19 pandemic. This is changing the way we live, the way we do things moving forward, the way we live together as a society. It will change the way we carry out our work, how our workplaces will be organized, how we raise our children, and how we take care of the elderly, how we organize learning in our schools and in our communities. If we learn anything from history, and I hope we will, we should, COVID-19 would be like the Spanish flu of 1918, it will be with us for at least 3 years until sufficient vaccines have been developed and distributed so that herd immunity can be developed. So, until this time, it means that we should be prepared to continue to do social distancing and carry out all the health protocols to keep everybody safe until 2023. It's a longer ride than we expected, but we have to buckle down and prepare for this. So the time horizon is threefold. The first is the immediate, which is where we are today. The second is the near future, up to five to seven years. And we have to ask ourselves, where will we be during this period? What will we be doing? And the long term is 7 to 10 years and beyond. What do we do to make our country a safe place? What this pandemic is teaching us is that the world and the future are uncertain. are full of unknowns. We call this a VUCA world, where VUCA stands for volatility, uncertainty, complexity, and ambiguity. To manage through such a world, we need to equip ourselves to work smarter, to work together in teams, and to collaborate so that we get through this together. By doing so, we can share expertise, offset our weaknesses with the strengths of others, and vice versa. And together, we can build resilience. These are the 21st century skills that we talk about in the classroom. Now, we should go out and do it in the real world. In this, I'm reminded of an African proverb. Quote, "If you want to go fast, go by yourself. If you want to go far, go with others, go together." End of quote. We need to go far, and we need to go together. Just look at the way we have to collaborate globally to develop the vaccines needed for the world so that we can all build herd immunity. We need to distribute these to all the countries, especially the poorer ones. That's what this pandemic is teaching us. You are all, or at least most of you, are professional teachers. What you learned in your undergraduate or your graduate studies is good knowledge. But in a fast-changing world, this is likely to change, and you are going to have to figure out what to do with your colleagues, how to make the adjustments moving forward. Education will change. The way children learn, the way schools are organized, the way lessons are delivered. This will change either incrementally or dramatically. And not just because of the situation caused by COVID-19. Even before COVID-19, we were already having to think about what we needed to do with our education system, because our children, our school children, were not doing well in international standard tests and assessments. Their levels of reading, of math and science, of overall learning, were well below the world average. And not just below the world average, they were one or two standard deviations below the world average. With these kinds of results, we need to restructure our education system. We need to make the changes for the future. The way we govern will have to change. Too many of our people, especially those in the lower classes of society, are not getting the basic services they need to lead quality lives. We run elections every 3 or 6 years. People are voting, but are they voting wisely for leaders who are taking responsibility for their actions and can be held accountable for it? Or is this a circus every 3rd or 6th years to elect individuals who don't even know or have a clue about how to govern? The way society takes care of its own has to change, will have to change. From the way we take care of the elderly to the way we take care of the disabled, from the neglected to the abused and discriminated, to those left behind in hard-to-reach areas and those in conflict zones. So what can you do as newly minted graduates of education? For starters, help develop a new generation of educated critical thinkers who can develop. What can you do as newly minted graduates of education? For starters, help develop a new generation of educated critical thinkers. Help develop this new generation of Filipinos who can think critically, solve real-world problems, address new dilemmas, create new work, new jobs, new industries that will help grow this country and make it a strong state. Collaborate to build a stronger, more inclusive, more resilient society. If this sounds familiar, it's because these are the 21st century skills that you were taught in the classroom. This is how functioning democracies operate and thrive. And this is what we need to make the Philippines a better country for all. As teachers, you play an integral role in all of this. Do it well. On occasions like this, I look to those who came before us for lessons that we can learn. Alfredo Jose Luz Sr., my father, was an architect whose best work was done in the 1960s. There are three structures of his that are particularly noteworthy. The first is the Ramon Magsaysay Center on Ross Boulevard. The second is the World Health Organization building United Nations Avenue in Manila. And the third is the International Rice Research Institute in Los Baños, Laguna. All three buildings were designed in the modernist style, but with classic elements and future-looking perspectives. My father had a philosophy that governed how he looked at things in the world and how he designed things. He would tell me this philosophy in three simple rules. And I think these rules can apply to many fields, including the field of education. Rule number one, if you build anything, build it to last. There is no point in building anything that will become obsolete soon. Rule number two, if you build anything to last, make it a thing of beauty for all to appreciate and to enjoy. Good architecture, beautiful architecture, will enrich the soul of man, my father would say. Rule number three, for anything to last forever, maintenance is important. Do not just build, invest in maintenance. Without maintenance, things deteriorate very quickly. The same applies to being a teacher. Build children's character and develop their minds. Build it and shape it so that it lasts the test of time. Make it a thing of beauty, as evidenced by their work, their writing, their creativity. But also instill a love for continuous learning, so that even in their adult years, they will continue to learn. They will continue to grow. This is what makes civilization so rich. The ability to continually regenerate itself, innovate, discover new things. If my father was a lesson from the past, I'd like to turn to Maria Ressa for lessons for the present and for the future. Maria Ressa is a Filipino journalist who was just awarded the Nobel Peace Prize for this year. The first Filipino so honored, and we really should take great pride in this. This is not an easy achievement to be recognized and to be awarded for. Maria Ressa has over the past decade and more been a tireless advocate for press freedom and truth in the face of the manufactured lies and falsehoods that are being passed around in social media as news today. This fight for press freedom is at the heart of a functioning democracy. Maria Ressa, quoting Ted Snyder, said that in a world of social media, an uncritical statement, a lie repeated a million times, begins to be believed by people as truth, even if it is not. This is why facts and responsible journalism matters. Maria Ressa said, without facts, you cannot have truth. Without truth, you cannot build trust. End of quote. If you don't have trust, you have a divided and weak society. News used to be delivered by news outlets and professionally trained journalists. Today, social media allows anybody to post their own version of news. Maria Ressa says, quote, "The social media platforms have taken over the distribution of news globally. They treat a lie the same way you would treat a fact. This is what is being done deliberately by getting it repeated thousands, if not millions of times by paid hacks, by trolls, and by bots, to a point where people begin to take this as a fact. By developing critical thinkers who can spot these falsehoods for what they are, to spot these lies and to speak out against it. This will help build a stronger society and a stronger democracy. This is why what we do as teachers matters. If we can develop a new generation, a new nation of critical thinkers, we don't have to be led by a circus of politicians making promises they do not keep, doing acts that abuse the powers of their office, and neglecting the people until they need their vote every 3 or 6 years. This pandemic will not last forever, but if the Spanish flu is any indication, it will be with us for another 1 to 2 years. To deal with this moving forward, we will have to adopt new ways of doing things that may continue to morph. Are you up to this challenge, especially in your chosen field of education? I hope you are, for the sake of our children, our learners, our communities, and our people. Let me end with verses from a poem I wrote about hope in these difficult times. The world can be a harsh place, but we have seen worse. War crimes, genocide, droughts and floods, wildfires, wars, a pandemic curse. For every negative, there are stories of hope. An Oscar Schindler saving thousands from death in Nazi furnaces, a Sicilian island community rescuing boatloads of refugees from death in floating coffins, drifting in an unforgiving sea. A girl attacked at home, now championing girls' education. A daughter of a Hmong immigrant, growing up to be an Olympic champion. The world can be a dangerous place, but the spirit of man has always uncovered new possibilities, new worlds, new things to be discovered. Let the world know of these endeavors, however big or small, to be inspired, to be encouraged, to rise up every time we fall. For civilization to grow stronger, for humankind to expand its scope, let the world be richer by these stories. Let the world move forward, driven by hope. Congratulations to the graduates of FEU Roosevelt. Go forth into the world, make yourselves and all of us proud of you.
Thank you, Trustee Juan Miguel M. Luz.
At this moment, we will be awarding the plaque of appreciation to our commencement speaker. The plaque reads, FEU Roosevelt, Cainta, Philippines, presents this plaque of appreciation to Juan Miguel M. Luz in grateful recognition of his participation as guest of honor and speaker during the 63rd commencement exercises of the Tertiary Education Division in the 56th commencement exercises of the Graduate School of Education. Given this 21st day of November 2021 in the city of Cainta, Philippines. Signed, Mr. Aurelio R. Montinola III, Chairman, Board of Trustees, and Dr. Michael M. Alba, President. This time, the President of FEU Roosevelt, Dr. Michael M. Alba, will deliver his message to our graduates.
Congratulations to the graduates of FEU Roosevelt Class of 2021. Since March of 2020, you have been constrained by community lockdowns, travel bans, and social distancing. To be limited in social interaction must have challenged your emotional reserves and overall state of well-being. So completing your studies speaks volumes about how you have exhibited resilience, competence, and integrity despite the virtual nature of classes in your last school years. Even with these extraordinary circumstances caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, I believe that your school experience was still fruitful and engaging, given that you had the Canvas Learning Management System and Office 365 apps to efficiently accomplish schoolwork and MS Teams to interact in real time with your teachers and classmates. As you prepare to move on to the world of work, here are some things to think about. Creative breakthroughs often emerge when there are constraints that are either self-imposed or placed upon us. How will you respond to the challenges of your generation? Will you thrive as a 21st century worker? Will you be a responsible, civically engaged citizen? It is our hope that you continue to live by the FEU Roosevelt values. In whatever you aspire to do, be resilient, strive hard to be competent, and imbue yourselves with integrity. Never stop learning. Never stop developing your skills and competencies. Brave future obstacles. On behalf of FEU Roosevelt, I wish each of you a successful and meaningful life. Again, congratulations and good luck.
Mr. Jeffrey B. Copiaco, President of the Roosevelt College Alumni Federation, will now lead the graduates to the alumni oath-taking.
Please raise your right hand and read with me. I, and then state your name, as a member of Roosevelt College Cainta Alumni Association Incorporated, do hereby solemnly swear that I will faithfully discharge the duties inherent our organization, and that I will support and defend its constitution and bylaws, and that I impose this obligation upon myself voluntarily, without mental reservation or purpose of evasion. So help me God.
May we call on Ms. Bea Santos, summa cum laude, Master of Arts in Education, major in English, to lead our graduates as they recite their pledge of loyalty to their school, FEU Roosevelt.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. As a graduate, I promise to hold my diploma with untarnished honor and to commit myself to the service and glorification of my community, my alma mater, my country, and my God.
As we formally end today's virtual commencement exercises, we would like to invite our students, parents, guests, faculty, and staff to join us in the singing of the FEU hymn. On behalf of the management, faculty, and staff of FEU Roosevelt, we would like to thank all students for entrusting your education to us. Thank you for being part of this important milestone in these students' lives. Once again, this has been Mr. Kishia Nishino, your Educational Technology Supervisor and your Master of Ceremonies for this event. Thank you, and once again, good day.